Hello，你在？Okay, I think it should be stable now. It's on. It's working. Hello, how am I? I'm very well, thank you very much. As you came on, I was just trying to mount the camera on in the right way because I could hear it was about to start falling or something. I wouldn't like that to happen, so but I'm fine, thank you very much. Painting as usual. We got some really bad weather now, even though it's a May weekend. But yesterday could enjoy sunshine a bit. And yeah, we haven't planned anything else other than painting anyway. So the weather doesn't change that much. Thank you very much. Yes, my work is very specific and very time-taking, and it's all because I use traditional technique. You probably know already that my technique originates from the Middle Ages, and it's taught through apprenticeship, 5 years drawing and painting, 10 hours a day, every day. And so the results are due to this training. I don't credit anything to talent nor any other emotional type qualities, just to the traditional, strong traditional technique. I'm not going to change the angle. Yes, Cycleman. 5 years of an apprenticeship, that's when the kind of trait of the technique get kind of engraved into an artist's nervous system. So then they function on a different frequency. It does change an apprentice into a professional those years. I am 35, but very soon I'll be 36. Thank you very much for the Super Heart Award, Mr. Drummer, if I may call you that way. We are the same age. All right, that is interesting, yeah. You'll be 36 May 12th. Oh, interesting. Have I had my dinner? Well, we had a meal, but we're going to make a bigger one later. I'm a good painter, thank you. Oh, you're welcome for the super hard. I like your work. Thank you. Yes, 12 more days left of being 35. All right. Interesting. You're everywhere, man. Seems like you are very active here. Ah, you say to. It's normal, dear, because if he's my age, then that's his year, so he's gonna be everywhere. That's good. Yes, right. And I hope you enjoy it. Just don't eat it all at once. How long does it take me to finish a painting? It usually takes me about 2,000 hours for a completed oil on canvas masterpiece. But these. So my collection of six fourth-dimensional paintings, which are part of my private collection, these are going to take longer. Yes, 2,000 hours is about 40 to 50 layers of fine oil paint. Yeah, oil paintings are the most complete for medium for my art form, you see, because to me the medium, the techniques of I use pencil, aquarel, ink, oil, paint, doesn't really change that much. It's just that in oil paint I can fully represent the reality, the realism of my technique. I wish I could draw or paint. I'm just a drummer. Draw the drum. I thought they meant some kind of a drama, like an acting type or something. I thought it was an abbreviation of that. I think as long as you're not a drag queen, it's okay. Not a drunk, not a drag queen. As long as you are not a drag queen, it's all right. Even repeated. Ah, you understand. That's very well. You're not at all. Yeah, I focus, no problem, you see. I've been trained to work in a way so I can interact with people whilst working. At those days it was not for streaming purposes, but it very well fits within, because because of the fact that my technique is so rare, I asked my master to teach me in a way so as I'm working, I can interact with people and even with large number of people, because I never plan to take on any apprentices. And as I said, the technique is rare. So that was my way of dealing with it. That's why I was trying to work publicly. That's why I don't work anonymously as the masters of my technique originally did. Thank you. You see, a lot of things are involved in being open for interaction and being able to focus on work together with interacting with people. Some of them are easier to predict and known about, and some of them are less easy to guess and to know about. For example, repeating a lot of times the same thing is one of the things that can disturb some people, yet it's necessary, because people joining or coming in for the first time or coming closer to look at your working, they are never ready for what they see, and for you as a as an artist working publicly, they are all just public, but they aren't or just public. They are, each of them needs to be introduced to the topic. And thank you very much for an appreciate award. So yeah, so sometimes repeating the same thing can be like extremely difficult to deal with and the most distracting, more than like even some kind of strong verbal exchange type interactions or other things. Sometimes those slow wearing you down things can be very significant, and that's what you need to train as you want to do something in public. That's a good point. Also great advice. Yeah. Yeah, really stating the obvious, it's a lot of thing. It's a thing that people have a big problem with. Yet it is necessary. It's necessary for clarity, and that's sorely lacking. In a lot of domains. And even if you have introduced the topic right, sometimes you need to go back to starting point and anyway say it again. Like, that's what I all the time say about that I'm into girls, that I like girls, and I'll repeat it all over and over again because I want it to be known and clear. My inspiration comes from beautiful young natural females. That's one of those things. Or like when I explain the technique, I have to start from the starting point, and sometimes I need to do it over and over again. Because when I start from explaining something more particular, it can be dressed up by someone else into something else, and its origin is extremely important for the whole context. I really don't like repeating myself at all. I have a hard time with it somewhat. Yes, I understand. It was difficult for me too. But you have to understand that anyone outside of you is a completely different entity. So they may not only have not heard it before from you, if they come to meet you first, but they may not even be bored by hearing it again. You might be bored yourself by repeating yourself. But somebody may need it as a confirmation, something, and reassurance. So yeah, to try to put yourself in another position, not just as you, and then you will have no problem with it. You don't like hearing your own voice. Ah, right. That's why you droom, and you can droom so loud that you don't have to hear it. Yes, I have a very good day. Thank you. About the art I'm working on, that's one of my 6 fourth dimensional paintings, which are all part of my private collection. Started working on a lot of 6 over 2 years ago. All right. Thanks for sharing that, Denise. That's good advice. It really is. Thank you. You're welcome. Yeah, that's one of the subtle difficulties of working in public. There are, of course, other ones, and with streaming it's different, and in reality it is also different, like doing projects in public. There is a, that's why I'm happy streaming, because it channels the concentration into the most essentially important part of interaction. Because you know, in reality, I have to be careful sometimes, because sometimes there are people who try to destroy the painting or something, so I have to be physically more careful. And like this, it boils down to the very important exchange of perception of painting and conversations. Yes, I am very white, I know. I do dream really loud, but to play inside for like a sound box, if that makes any sense, because I play so loudly. Yeah. I think if you don't like your own voice, try not to think about it, and not to think about your preference for your voice. Just try to think about what would you like another person to get from you as a message, rather than your voice or something like that, because you get lost in it. and enjoy broadcasting, dreaming, and meeting new people and making new friends from around the world, like viewers and some. That's right. Yeah, I think you should think about your voice or your speech, not as a means to please or unnerve yourself, but as a means to transfer the message to the others in the most precise form you can. And then you won't bother about it bothering you, either about the form of your voice or you having to repeat yourself. I did that. I tried to think too loud with my voice sounds like. And just open. Yeah, try not to think about what it sounds like. Yes, just try to concentrate on the message you're trying to pass on. You're welcome. Having a good talking in a while, and thank you for inviting talking to me. No problem. Do I anything else besides paint, like hobbies? No, I don't, to be honest. And painting isn't my hobby, it's my profession, and I treat it very much so. Another one of my professions is haute couture, fashion design of hand-stitched prototypes. Yeah, I did fashion shows in Berlin. I did Berlin Fashion Week, Milan Fashion Week, Lviv Fashion Week, different shows of fashion in French Riviera. You had to think of something to say. That's no problem. But I don't have hobbies, and I'm not looking for any. I guess I'm too serious for that. When I do something, I take it very seriously, and I wouldn't like to waste time on something that I don't want to. Don't treat lightly. I don't treat things like hobbies. Everything has very big importance to me. So whatever, everything has big importance to me. But you know, art is my profession, and I don't, and I've never had a job like work like people do. And then those people who work in a regular, usual type of work, they like to have a hobby as a balance of such lifestyle. But I never had a job, so I don't treat things as hobbies. People say you're too serious too. That's interesting. Yeah. And it's the same as holidays. I don't go on holidays. If I go somewhere, it's the purpose. That makes sense because music is my job. I understand it makes sense why we now go on holidays. No, because if I go somewhere, it's to do something there. And if I was to go somewhere and I see a beautiful landscape, it's just another one of the subjects of my work. It's not a thing to relax over. I respect all work and no play. Yeah, in a way, that's right. That's what I consider to be development. That's at some point it becomes that. Probably, all the play and fun and hobby and holidays, it was before, and it was for the purpose of defining myself into what I have become now. And I don't go back to things like that. When the shoe becomes too small for your foot, you wear another shoe. happen to turn a hobby and a simple of music into a job, and even went to university to study music too. So one of my hobbies is also my job. All right. In my understanding of things, it's all one or another. One activity, I couldn't treat something as both at the same time. Or either you take it seriously and then you are consequent with it, or not. Let you read a good book, walking, hiking, normal stuff, and I guess. All right. I think what interests me are other things that are more unusual and unique. The so-called normal, the comfort of so-called normal, I don't find appealing at all. So what interests me are interesting, unique, different things. Very much love what I do. I've been banging on stuff since I was 2 years old. And there's also, I have no non-emotional approach to my profession. So I wouldn't say that I love what I do, not in any way. I have no emotions towards my work. And that you said, yes, I understand. Yeah, that's how it starts, but you should take yourself now and I wouldn't work. Sure. Okay. This is not too. That's right. You told me something, and I said doing something. You're welcome. Thank you for the ha high five award. Thank you, Leah. I do keep your sign. Oh, no problem. But I think soon, either, and then I will. Yeah, I think oh, let's see. Yeah. You see, for me, when I was learning to work publicly, it's also very surprising. It was a situation, I mentioned it once before already, but it's no problem to mention it again. I was painting in a field outdoors, and I was painting a meadow full of grass, and each blade of grass I was painting individually there. And I thought that for people watching me, so for my public, which was at that time a physical public in a real space, I thought it would be extremely boring. I thought they would be really disappointed, and well, I thought it made no sense to have a public and paint each blade of grass, but it turned out to be the most interesting for them, and the feedback of the people watching, that's what made me understand that it's completely different from their point of view than I thought. So I have also realized that it's pointless of me to make all those assumptions about how somebody else can perceive things based on my point of view. Completely pointless, because they were very interested in just watching each blade of grass being painted individually. And that is also what differentiates my technique from the other techniques. So that is, in a way, my duty to show it as I decided to break the tradition of working anonymously and paint publicly. I never do things for show in a different way that I do in order to complete a painting, drawing, or an aquarelle. I've never done anything differently because it is a show, but I thought that some parts of the creative process are not interesting to show, and I was wrong, because I was wrong about what is interesting for people to see and what isn't. So, I stopped trying to predict, and I just concentrate on doing my thing. And I simply show what's practical at the time. you are concerned with the military venture and professional and respectful. They had to find before I did. Thank you for subscribing, Nerby.